Hi students, today I'll be discussing about IoT network architecture and design. Yes, let me quickly move on to the presentation. Moving on to the next slide. Yeah, IoT network architecture and design. Architecture is meant with group of components or group of elements together only we can call it as an architecture. So we can define this network architecture is a system with a group of components or elements in IoT. So which is with sensors, actuators, protocols, cloud services, layers, complete things which make this IoT network system. So we are going to talk about all these things which are a part of this IoT network architecture and design, right? So there are some challenges also that we could see with IT and then OT, and also there are some similarities between an IT and OT architectures. So the challenges and requirements of these IoT systems, they are IT and then OT, they are different from each other, and there are some similarities and also there are some challenges. So the challenges by the IoT networks, what we have seen that have driven with new architectural models, we could see here within the slide the new architectural models based on the challenges from these IoT networks are drivers behind the new network architectures, what are the different types of drivers, and comparing the IoT architectures. So this is a main important thing, comparing the IoT architectures and the simplified IoT architecture. As a part of the simplified IoT architecture, the two components which we could see is core IoT functional stack and IoT data management and computing stack. There is a small difference between comparing IoT architecture and simplified IoT architecture. Under comparing IoT architecture, we could see the complete reference model of IoT architecture and design. Under simplified architecture, the number of layers were reduced and same functionality we could do in a better way. So that is all about the introduction to IoT network architecture and design. Let me move on to the first concept of this architectural model, which is drivers behind the new network architecture. Okay. So before going to this drivers behind the new network architecture, there are different areas, different reasons for the design of the IoT network. So IoT network is dependent on all these components or all these elements. So before going for this drivers behind the new network architecture, let us go for a simple process of this components. So what is this drivers behind the new network architecture means? We know like IT and then OT functionality. One has to support the other, like OT and then IT. Like IT, which is it will be mainly providing the services, and OT the operating technology, everything, right? So operating technology networks will have the core drivers to support various applications. Like let us consider the industrial business operations. To support that business operations, like this operating technology should have the separate drivers, separate network drivers. So all these network drivers which are depend on the applications, they will be having different characteristics and different limitations which are not easily supported by the IT network. Is that clear? So for this background, like we need to go ahead with the different set of drivers for different set of applications, because that much easily this OT and then IT may not get the mutual support. So this is the concept behind the drivers from this new architectures. Next, comparing the IoT architectures. I said already IT and then OT, there are few similarities and few differences. with this comparison of IoT architectures, like we could go with this ETSI and IoT World Forum. IoT World Forum is inclusive of the reference layers from the IoT architecture. ETSI is nothing but the European Telecom Standards Institute. So where while developing any of the particular architecture standards, it will have a key for the information and communication technology. So the architectures will be published for IoT, which is included by this ETSI and then IoT World Forum. So with this, we can compare the architectures. The next one is a simplified IoT architecture. Simplified, as I mentioned, IoT World Forum, it is a main IoT architecture with a complete 7 layers, where the layers were brought it down, and the performance of that particular simplified IoT architecture will improve with the reduced layers based on the operating functionality. So we know that already some of the IoT architectures were already existed. Like the simplified model will be just like a foundation for the rest of the architectures, right? How it can go for the foundation for the rest of the architecture means, like we know that OSI ISO reference model, and again the number of layers were brought it down in different architectures as per the functionality of the application. The similar manner, we know the IoT World Forum with the reference layers, but though we try to go with the simplified IoT architecture, wherein which the number of layers functionalities can be combined here, and we could see the same response or a better response from the architecture. That was the background behind this simplified IoT architecture. The next two were about the core IoT functional stack and IoT data management and compute stack. They are the part from the simplified IoT architecture. The core IoT functional stack, which will be designed mainly to support the requirements of the architecture and any limitations or constraints for that. So that is about the core elements. And IoT data management and compute stack, here how the data, what kind of data is generated, how the data can be managed. Managed in the sense which is included with the storage, different types of resources what we have as a part of IoT architecture, and along with this the main elements what we have here is edge computing, fog and cloud computing mechanisms. Everything is there as a part of the IoT data management and compute stack. This is just like a overview from this. The next one we will see drivers behind the new network architecture. Okay, you can see the drivers behind the new network architecture. The background process what I explained is there are several issues behind this drivers behind the network architectures. There may be similarities or there may be several issues, whatever it may be. Let us see the issues. The challenges or issues here are scalability, security, the devices and networks constrained by the power, CPU, memory, etc. and volume of the data which is generated, support from the support for the legacy devices, and the need for the data to be analyzed in the real time. So let us look for the first one. First, scalability. And remember one thing, all these were the reasons why we have come out with the set of new drivers for the establishing of new network architectures. Due to all these reasons, we have come out with different drivers for different set of applications based on these challenges. Yes, scalability, we know that it is just like an enhancement. It's not always feasible to go for enhancing the network. There should be an endpoint. Beyond that, we cannot enhance. So with this scalability, like, we need to go the architectural change which is required. Always this IPv4 will not be supportive with this scalability requirements. Again, we have to go for IPv6. Because the address translation is keep on required when we are enhancing the network. Next one is about the security. IoT devices like especially wireless sensor networks and the other category of the networks will be exposed to the world. It means to say security is another challenging job. We know that every level of the network we require the security. So there is a problem here to assign the security. Frequency and impact of the cyber attacks in the recent years were completely increasing. Protecting the corporate data from the intrusion and theft is one of the main functions of the IoT network, and it is the main role of the IT department as well. So security is one of the important aspects for this drivers behind the new network. So the next one is devices and network constrained by the power, CPU, memory and then link. So there are massive scale of distances, and the networks are often constrained, and there is a lot of data loss and capable of supporting minimum data rates. There are so many issues still we are facing. So what exactly it means to say is IoT sensors, whatever we are taking, they are designed for the simple job. Small and expensive, this means they often have limited power, CPU and memory, and they transmit only where there is some important. Because of this massive scale and longer distances, like it will be a problem. So devices and networks constrained by CPU, memory and link speed, like this is one of the another challenges to new network architectures, right? The massive volume, next one is the massive volume of data generated. Yes, the massive volume of data generated is one more important thing. In IT network, like we work with multi gigabit connection speeds and endpoints with powerful CPUs. Because IT network has its own performance constraints, solution is as simple as it is. To upgrade the faster network, we are going behind the massive volume of data generated. So it may cause some of the bottlenecks, slow analytics in the cloud. So to avoid all these things, again we have to go for massive volume of data generated. This is one more important thing. Next one is support for legacy devices. IoT often it will go with the collection of IP capable endpoints, non-IP devices which are really serve the purpose of data transformation. Data transformation, we know, like it is a long process. Completely the IT and then OT networks need to support each other, and with the help of these protocols, standard protocols such as Ethernet and then IP. So supporting the devices with a collection of IP and non-IP devices which completely rely on the protocols. This is one of the challenging factors, because IoT is having connectivity challenges based on both the scalability and limitations. That is one more thing. In OT systems, end device, they are likely to be on the network for a long time. Sometimes it may be decades. So we need to see that IoT networks are deployed properly, and they need to support with the older devices which are already present in the network. It's not like always we come up with a new. The last point under drivers behind the new network architecture is need for the data to be analyzed in the real time. Yes, the data to be analyzed in the real time, because IoT devices generate a mountain of data. Unlike the IT networks and OT networks are designed to stagger the data consumption throughout the architecture, both the filter and reduce the unnecessary data here. So to provide the fastest possibility response to the devices, it is necessary to go with the data which is to be analyzed. So traditional IT networks will go with the batch processing of data, means the data need to be analyzed and need to be responded in a real time. the complete analytics needs closer to the real-time system analytics. Yes, these are the drivers behind the network architecture. The rest of the topic we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.